What's up, y'all? I'm here at Revival Fitness, probably my favorite gym at the moment. Being 24 hours, that works really well for me because gotta make sure my mic is on. Yeah, that works really well. It works well for me because my schedule sometimes is all over the place. And even when it's not, I like to go to the gym when I feel ready. Bad boy, sit down. Sit down. I like to go to the gym when I'm ready to go. And whenever that may be first thing in the morning, that may be after a couple meals, that may be after my clients, and that might be at midnight, which is 12:19 a.m. right now. I done lost my train of thought. Anyways, yeah, right now this is whenever I feel ready to go is when I'm gonna go, and this gym makes that possible. And besides that, it also has some of the best old school equipment that there is to offer here. And well, this is OC actually, but which is pretty far because I live in West Hollywood, but I don't really care how far it is as long as I get the kind of workout I'm trying to get. But I got legs. And I seem to like to film on leg day just because, at least for YouTube, just for some reason, leg days is the days that I have a lot to say. Well, sometimes I have nothing to say at all, but I get a lot of emotions on leg day, let's say that. Just because leg day is difficult, so you know it's gonna take a lot out of you. So when I can let my emotions free, it kind of gives me that extra push. You know, as men, I feel like a lot of times we bottle our emotions up. Just, I guess, as a coping mechanism, just because, I don't know, we gotta, men have a lot to take on. Men have a lot to take on. Not to say women don't have a lot to take on. I'm not saying that at all, but it's just very different, you know. I think most women would be alarmed if they got to. I guess saying it would be if they got to, let's say, walk in our shoes for a day. I think they would be surprised because I don't think they really know what we go through because we're not as expressive as they are. So we don't really express our feelings very well, if at all. So usually, you know, I don't think women really know what we go through or how much we have to carry on our backs, you know, on a regular basis, just because I don't think men are that expressive with their feelings. And I don't know if, I don't even know if we should be all the time. I think there's a time and place for it, but at the end of the day, shit has to get done. So, you know, sometimes I hear women say, you should be more emotional or, you know, things like that. And I mean, I believe men are very emotional. I think a lot of men are just as emotional as women. Sometimes even more. We just express it differently. I don't know. We kind of keep it bottled up. But anyway, I got off on a tangent. But yeah, we tend to bottle things up. So on leg days, I like to not bottle it up and let myself feel emotion just because I know what that's going to do to the workout. You know, because there's a lot of stuff down there buried up deep down inside that could be useful on a leg day, and so I let myself feel it. If I also let myself feel all my emotions all the time, that wouldn't be conducive to my life or work or anything like that, because I wouldn't get much done because I would be in my feelings, you know, which is not where I need to be most of the time. But you know, this would be the day to do it. So if you notice that I post a lot of leg days, especially quads on YouTube, that would be why. But in other news, this is my second day back in the gym. Let me make sure the camera's still on because this shit sometimes be bugging. But like I was saying, yeah, it's actually my second day back in the gym. It's a quad day. And I was out the gym for a full week. I couldn't tell you if I don't think I've ever taken a full week off the gym besides when I was in a coma. But that's a story for another day. That's the last time, or probably the only other time I've ever taken a week off from the gym. But I've never taken a week off the gym intentionally. You know, granted, you can't. I don't know if you can call it being sick intentionally, but I needed it. But I've been sick plenty of times, and I've been to the gym despite being sick. But second day back in the gym. So rough week. I missed Thanksgiving. Didn't get to hang out with my family. Didn't get to enjoy the food. But that's okay. I can make up for it a different day. You know. But I actually also just literally got into a car accident like 30 minutes ago. I was in a car accident. Older lady in front of me hit the brakes hard, and then I hit the brakes and didn't make it in time, and I rammed straight into her. It wasn't her fault. Somebody in front of her braked as well, so I would say it's nobody's fault. It's just one of the shit that, you know, some of the things that happen in life. It is what it is. But Kane was a little shaken up. He was kind of like crying. He can't fit the doggy seat, so he kind of just lays there. So he kind of flew into the foot area. I don't even know what to call it. It doesn't seem like he was hurt. He was just a little surprised, a little taken back, a little scared, because he heard the loud noise and all that shit. But yeah, so as you can imagine, she was shaken up, but I was super polite to her, and she really appreciated that. And she was super polite to me, so that was a good interaction. It's not always the interaction you get when you're in an accident. But I feel like I'm babbling a little bit, but I'm just trying to be transparent and just say what's on my mind, you know. And as weird as this sounds, I feel like I kind of needed that, you know. I feel like I kind of needed the accident. Oddly enough, sounds like a weird thing to say. It is a weird thing to say, but I think I look at life differently than a lot of people do, you know. I hate to compare traumas and compare hardship, but just from my observation, a lot of people have never been through anything in life. Like, nobody wants to hear that because it sounds like a insult. I don't believe in the insult at all. I believe it's a privilege, and privilege isn't a negative thing, even though I think in society people attach a negative connotation to privilege. But most people just haven't been through shit in life. So any little thing that happens, people bug the fuck out and feel bad for themselves, and woe is me, every little stop. And that shit sometimes irks me. I'm sorry, I don't like to judge people, but that shit irks me. Everybody got some story to complain about, and it's like, are we just gonna sit around and complain? We live in America, first of all. Like, a lot of y'all have no idea what goes on around the world. Y'all think this is hard, you know, life in general. Well, if I say it's hard, what am I comparing it to? Like, what do you compare hard to? Other countries or other times in history? This is the easiest time to be alive. Our parents had it harder. Our parents' parents had it harder. Our great-great-great-great-great-grandparents had it way harder than us. So it gets easier. It doesn't get harder. So hard compared to what? Is it hard? Most people's lives is way too easy. That's why you can't handle shit, because your life is too easy. You know, but anyway, I'm getting off on a separate tangent. But I think it was good for me to get into the accident, because I kind of had a moment of clarity, and I felt like I haven't been locked in. I haven't been locked in for this whole year. I love prep because I feel so locked in. I'm always locked in prep in general, but just in life, I haven't felt locked in for a little bit now. honestly, this entire year I've been kind of off. It's been a rough year for me, and I just haven't been locked in. I feel like I kind of lost that edge, that grind. You know, I'm from New York, and you know, New York teaches you a different kind of grind, a different kind of hustle. And then when I moved to Cali about 7 years ago now, 2024, yeah, 7 years ago exactly, a little over 7 years ago, I felt like LA was easy, you know? So depending where you come from, LA could be harder than where you came from, right? For most people, wherever you move from, come to LA, you're probably like, whoa, this city is so fast-paced and expensive and this and that. Coming from New York, go the opposite. I felt like, whoa, this is so chill. This is so, I don't want to say easy. Easy is pushing it. But this is so much more relaxed than New York. And I slowly lost that New York mindset. And I was proud of it because I don't want to be on edge forever. I don't want to be just always grind, you know, all the time, because you never get to live life that way. But that's how I was. And I came here, I did the same thing. Grind. Fucking 6 years, grind, head down, grind. And I grind really fucking hard. I didn't have any money saved up when I moved here. I had no money, no job, no anything. I had like, my account was in the negative, believe it or not. After a couple of weeks of being here with no job, my account was in the negative, and I was in like 20 grand in debt, you know? So I had no choice but to grind, and I grind, paid off all the debt, and was able to create a decent life for myself. And I think I got comfortable, you know? All my bills was paid. I was able to buy like nice cars. I was able to live in a nice place in West Hollywood. When I first moved here, I lived in the hood, in a pretty nasty neighborhood. You know, the normal shit, the norm. At the time, it didn't feel that bad because I was used to it being from the projects in the Bronx. So liquor stores and prostitutes and shootings and all that shit, that's normal, you know. That's normal. It's not going to phase you if that's all you know. So I didn't mind. In hindsight, I'm like, that shit is nasty. But at the time, you know, when it's all you know, so you don't give a fuck. So I was able to do that, and then being in a nice position, or decent position, depending on who you compare it to, I guess. It was nice for me, at least. You know, West Hollywood is nice for me, driving nice car and shit. I think I got comfortable, and I feel like I lost that fire. And you know, life was good for me. Like I said, for some people probably wasn't good, but for me it was good. And I think I just got comfortable, and I really lost that fire. I slowly started losing that fire. Let's say that, because I was still grinding my ass off, but I slowly was losing that fire, and I felt like I got lazy. You know, once again, for my standards, it's lazy. Depends who you ask. You know, depends who you ask. For me, I would consider it lazy, and I feel like I just been living. I haven't been living. I feel like I've just been alive and just going through the motions, but I haven't really been living. And I feel like I'm ready to lock in. I honestly feel like I'm ready to lock in, you know, and not just one place or another. Not like I'm a lock in on bodybuilding or I'm a lock in on work. I just want to lock in on everything and be very precise and direct like I used to be. Everything had intent. There's no wasted time. There's no wasted minute. There's no wasted second. You know, anything that's not for me gets pushed the fuck out with no empathy. Just like, if you're wasting my time, or if this is wasting my time, or this is not for me, I have no time or sympathy for it. And that got me pretty far being that way. And I kind of just stopped being that way. I kind of really got soft. I mean, and I was proud of getting soft, because shit, how long are you gonna be hard forever? You know, at some point, I want to be soft. I want to work so hard and be able to be soft, so I could just be a soft old man and a soft, rich, happy old man. You know, that should be the goal for everybody. But I ain't there yet. You know, and I think I took a step back, honestly. I feel like I took a step back because I got too comfortable. So it's time for me to kind of like stop just being alive and start going harder in life again. And I kind of miss going hard in life, just making every minute count and grinding as hard as possible and then reaping the rewards too. I miss it. I miss all of it. I miss the lifestyle. I miss the feeling. I miss the adrenaline. And I'm ready to get back into it. So this leg day is kind of symbolic for me. It's my first leg day back, and I want to tap into that zone again and be that same person that I was at one point. And it doesn't mean I can't have fun and laugh and be soft sometimes, but I think it's time for me to really lock in and get back in that zone. I feel like I need it, But the break could have been necessary. The mental break could have been necessary because I was burnt out. I was really burnt out. Going hard all the time, grinding all the time. You can burn out. And I'm 32. I've been grinding. I've been grinding all my life, man. I've been grinding as long as I can remember that. You know, that's life for some people. Everybody isn't blessed enough or privileged enough to be born with, well-off parents and, live a nice childhood and go to college and get a good job and live in a nice house and all that. I'm sure that's great. And a lot of people don't get to live that. A lot of people start from the bottom, fucking bread and water and shit as a kid and sleeping on the floor, the whole night, A lot of us ain't never seen a fucking proper bed till we were adults, I didn't have my own room. None of us, we didn't have no rooms. We literally didn't have a bed, slept on the floor for my entire childhood, And that's not as, I know some people hearing that might be like, what? But that's pretty fucking common. Where I'm from, that's pretty fucking common. It's shit. Some people have an air mattress, some people don't. Some people lay shit on the floor, that's not that uncommon. I'm sure some people can relate, and some people are probably just like, what? That sounds crazy. But that's the reality of life, So I'm a far cry from sleeping on the floor now, but I still have a ways to go. This is not the ceiling for me, and I'm trying to reach that ceiling, so I'm gonna do whatever it takes to reach that ceiling. So that's enough talking. Time to get busy, so let me hit this fucking workout. Quad day. All right, first working set on leg extensions. What am I saying? First exercise of the workout, we're doing leg extension, so I'm about to hit my first working set. This is the flex. Flex leg extension, one of my favorites. We're gonna start, the way I'm gonna run this workout basically is two top sets. One top set and a back down set, depending on how many reps I get. I may stay at the same weight or do a back down set. So let's get a feel for it, But things are always subject to change, but right now that's the game plan, how we gonna run it. Top set, back down set, move on. So check it out. Oh. 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 That shit felt light. All right, so I don't have the gym pin on me, so I'm gonna do the same weight, just with less rest. So instead of probably my usual, minute to 2 minutes rest, I guess. Yeah, I guess it depends on legs, maybe more. I'm only gonna rest it's probably been 40 seconds. So let's call it a minute. Hey, leave her alone. Leave her alone. Hey. He's trying to play with you.
I'm trying to
sleep
my dog.
Oh, yeah? Oh, like he's trying to go play with you. Hey, leave her alone. Come here. No, not here. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit. Good boy. All right, second exercise, first working set. Honestly, I felt super weak on the warm-up, so I'm not gonna try to play myself. I'm gonna work with this. This is gonna be more than enough today. And as the off-season progresses, I should be able to work up to sixth place for sets of 10, and then hopefully work up to a PR. I would love to get up to four place each side, because it only counts for one side. We don't count both sides. So two plates today, and then I should be able to work up pretty quickly because, mind you, I'm not at baseline right now. I'm coming from sickness, so my true baseline would be a bit higher, so this wouldn't be a progression. This would be, you get what I'm saying, this would be a little bit lower than usual, so the progression should be a lot faster than if I was start from, you know, scratch. Fuck, man. Even though the flu is gone, I still got some phlegm and mucus. Sit down. Still got some phlegm there. I literally swallowed a fucking snot ball mid-set. I don't know if the mic picked that up. But I snorted a fucking booger ball mid-set. And it kind of fucked up my breathing. As shitty as my cardio is right now, that's not ideal. But still gotta finish the set strong. Can't let fucking snot can't fuck up your set. You let snot fuck up your set. Shit, you're in the wrong sport. Alright, third movement, are we doing I don't really know what the fuck this is actually. It feels like a front squat, that's what I know. It's called a power squat. Okay, I don't know what company it is. I have no idea what the fuck this is. But it feels like a front squat, that's how I can explain it. So I like how it feels, so I'm gonna do it. That's all that matters. I don't have to know the technical term. Everything feels good in the gym, so can't really go wrong with leg days here. So, yeah, I'm gonna do a top set, back down set.
That's the chance to glow.
That wasn't too bad. 12 reps is a bit much for me. I like to keep it 8 to 10 personally, so I'll probably go up a bit. I don't want to make it an endurance contest here, so me personally, I'd rather have it around 10, so that's what I'm going to do. Final movement for quads. We're back to leg extensions. I'm gonna do single leg this time. Back and forth, no rest. Pretty much until I can't do anymore. So let's say like probably 4 or 5 sets. Until I can't do more than like 6 reps basically. The benefit of doing one leg at a time, I guess besides the obvious benefit of being able to isolate each leg, so you can create that symmetry. Everybody has a stronger side or a side that takes over when you do a bilateral movement. So this would single each out and you'll be able to spot your weaknesses, create a more symmetrical physique. But for me, if I use enough weight so that I can stay in my rep range, it gets harder and harder to keep my butt down. I can hold down as hard as I want. Just the amount of weight, the amount of force on my shin is slightly trying to pull me out of position. Whereas one leg at a time, my body weight is heavy enough that when I have less than half the stack instead of the full stack, it's not enough weight to lift my whole body up. So my butt is firmly planted and I can hold myself in the best position possible and get the best stretch and a full, complete range of motion. You know, I don't miss any inch of the movement. So that allows me to get a crazy stretch, crazy contraction without moving or trying to brace so hard my whole body. So that would be the benefits. But there's also benefit in doing both, right? Because you get the most amount of tension on the entire quads. You can create the most intensity you know, most intensity, and create the maximum overload, which is the benefit of doing a bilateral movement. So I do both. I start with the bilateral and finish with the unilateral. That's just something that I like how it feels personally, but some people, you know, just felt like sharing that. All right, that's a wrap for quad day. Successful workout, I would say. I mean, the pump is good. Intensity was where I expected it to be. I mean, where I wanted it to be. And there's no expectation, I guess, but that's where I wanted it to be. And strength, not quite where I wanted it to be. But like I said, I had no expectations, so I didn't expect to be strong or not strong. It's just, you know, it is the beginning of my cycle, but it's also losing about 10 pounds, being sick. So, I mean, you can't expect to be your strongest, but I wasn't my weakest, I guess, neither. I mean, fairly weak. I mean, you know, only comparison to myself, because can't compare myself to anybody else. But successful workout, it's not all about strength. It's about progression to some extent. And for me, it's intensity, man. I mean, if I give it my all, I don't have to worry about matching numbers because I have nothing else to give. So if I give my all, what different would I do when it comes to numbers? I couldn't give any more, regardless of what the numbers were. It's irrelevant because I gave all I had on that day. So as long as you do that every workout, you don't need a logbook, because a logbook, you're trying to pass something that's on record, which means I would assume that would mean you're giving it your all, because that should be the only way you can do that. And if you do that and you don't hit a PR, the fuck else you gonna do? You know, pop fucking 10 Anadrols? I mean, you gave everything your body had. You can't do any more than that. So that's all I'm trying to do at the end of the day. I don't need a logbook because I give it my all every single time I'm in here. So unless I plan to not give it my all. You know, today, yeah, I would say I gave it my all, considering, you know, if I'm at 80% recovered and I give 100% of 80%, that's still 100%. For that day, you know. So anyways, yeah, that's a wrap. I hope I was able to provide some content of substance, because there's so much content out there now, and a lot of it is nonsense, to be honest, you know, because it's not really their fault, it's YouTube's fault, because the algorithm is such that negativity and bullshit gets the most views. So people are so bent on views that they'll do anything to get views. I got into a back and forth with some guy online. This video popped up on my feed, and it was so silly. The guy took an injection, and he's like bleeding from his shoulder, and he's like, "This is the truth. If you want to be somebody in this industry, this is what it takes." And the guy, he told me he was like in his 30s, and he looked like he was 12 years old. He's like a little boy. He didn't even look natural. He looked like somebody who doesn't even work out, to me personally. And he's talking about, this is what it takes. How the fuck would you know what it takes? Nobody knows who you are. Nobody cares who you are. You're only getting these views and comments because you posted some stupid shit, and the entire comment section is telling you how stupid you are. And you think that's like substance. It's like so ridiculous. But I can't even fully blame him, because if you post just regular sound shit, it doesn't really get views, right? You get viewed by people who already know you, you know? It doesn't really grow your page. So I can understand if somebody wants to put the energy in the content, they wanted to get views to some extent, you know? We all want views to some extent. Just how bad do you want it? I mean, I would love if more people viewed my shit, but at the end of the day, I'm not finna get out here and act like a fucking fool or be somebody that I'm not, or show out for views. That's just corny, you know? Would I get more views? Sure. We all know the YouTube channels that do the negative shit. They get good views, but is that who you are, the man, bro? That's all you have to offer the world? Bullshit, just to get eyes on you? To each their own. I mean, to some people, attention and the possibility to make money is more important than their integrity. And who am I to judge? I'm not here to judge people at the end of the day. I'm not a judge. I'm not the jury. I'm just a guy. What do I know? But I think it's corny as fuck, personally. So I could never do that, you know. And I've had people tell me, like, I mean, all sorts of shit, like, from like, you should get more views, to you should try this, you should get more views, or don't have this person on your podcast, or you should have it. I don't really give a fuck, man. Whoever wants to come on can come on. Whoever doesn't want to come on, okay. Don't really give a fuck. I gotta be honest with you. I give a fuck about my podcast because I enjoy it. That's it. That's why I do it. I enjoy it. If I didn't enjoy it, I wouldn't do it. You know, it was monetized, so I was getting some checks from it. Now it's not monetized. I wish it was, but if it's not, it's all the same to me, man. I'm just a chill guy, you know, like that meme on Instagram. I'm just a chill guy living life. Life to me is about happiness. It's not about money. We all need money to live and survive. But other than that, man, I'm just past that at this point. I've had money. I've had no money. I've had kind of a decent range of having a good amount of money to no money. It is what it is. Happiness is happiness. And the most money I had didn't make me the most happy. So happiness first comes to me. So I'm going to just keep doing content the way I do it. People who like it, like it. People who think it's boring, think it's boring. It is what it is. I can't control what people like. I can't control the algorithm, and nor do I care to try. So I'm always going to be me till I die at the end of the day. Sponsors know that. If they don't, too bad. I mean, I just do me, man. As far as competing goes, I love competing. I love bodybuilding. I used to hate competing. I love training. Now I actually love competing as well. So I've grown to love it. So I do it because I love it. And, I don't think there's any other reason to compete. You don't compete for the money, you know. I don't want to hear, well, the Olympia is 600,000. Nobody's winning the Olympia. Like, none of you watching this video are gonna win the Olympia, with all due respect. So it's like, that's irrelevant. You can't. What? You're gonna do a sport for the chance to be five of the 1%? It doesn't make sense. You know? Samson Dowder is Miss Olympia, but he didn't bodybuild because he wanted to be rich. He bodybuilt because he loved it. That's it. So that's the only reason why you should, and that's why I do it. So I'm gonna keep doing it until I don't love it anymore. And whatever happens with that happens. Do I have goals? Yes, but that's not why I do it. I do it because I love it, and setting goals makes me hungry to do it. So, you know, that's how I look at it. Anyways, that's enough talking. Did a lot of talking today. Probably most of the footage is probably talking. But don't forget to buy a t-shirt at Team Macho that shop. I don't even remember my own site. Pretty sure it's Team Macho that shop, but I'm gonna write it down below. I'm tired, it's late, man. It's 2 a.m., so forgive me. Yeah, this video is coming to end. If you like the video, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Follow me on Instagram at Bodyfall. Email me for coaching at Team Macho with two O's at gmail.com. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.